to the back of my mind can compare to the sight you must be seeing. Now power has returned. I wish I could be there with you, but circumstances do not allow for such frivolity. Maybe soon there is something you can do about that. But tell me, are there ever melted conveyances now churning in the dark room? I think I know what they need. It is some kind of heaven or a utopia. We are now such good and lasting friends. I have gifted you with my love. Perhaps you could gift me with something. After all, the laws of politeness would be shattered if you were to appear at my party without a gift. Poor Red is so hungry. He could eat both the horse and the young rippling stable hand. Sadly, pony flesh is so hard to come by in these parts. Man meat is so... just so bland. If your eyes happened upon a scurrying rodent, would you deliver the crunchy feast by way of a final meal? while you hunt for those delicate, melt-in-your-mouth, mousy morsels, there are places you should not go, for fear of death. The Reaper lives here, just like you and I. And just like you and I, he must ingest the living flesh of those less fortunate than him. There is a small place that I do not want you to visit, even on your holidays, because it is dark and evil place that I've been. When the darkness has overwhelmed my small decaying mind, some bad things flowed from my mind and through my pen. The brilliant blue ink itself seemed to turn to blood into my grace. And by the way, should you turn peckish, red is at its finest sautéed with a little engine oil. far away I am. You cannot be far. I am held captive by a wall of stone in the northeast of the mountain. As in any drama, there are many roles to be played. You must act the scientist in mixing potions, act the renegade in plots of destruction. On your travels for the tools with which you will fashion my rescue, you may discover the place of my last meal. Be careful. The shiny, solid floor of water is not as solid as it seems. Poor Red was almost swallowed whole. The two foolsy men who plummeted into my domain have long since departed, though not, I expect, from whence they came. I ate ravenously of biped meat that day, but Red promises feasting only began when the men became pungent, when the stench of life had gone, and only the sweet aroma of decay remained. Imagine the feats of action man-like heroics you must be performing to save old Red. I am waiting so close now for you to blow down the walls of my earthbound prison cell and release me from this mortal coil.
fresh men, as it's fresh.